Another nice formatting option that Excel offers is to be able to designate a page break wherever you want on a page. You can set a page break a couple of different ways. You can use the breaks command on the page layout tab in the page setup group. Here it is, and notice if I select it, it allows me to insert a page break, remove a page break, or reset all page breaks. Notice that here on this demonstration worksheet, I have a dashed line that goes all the way down my page. This dashed line indicates that the page will break between columns D and E. As well as notice between rows 43 and 44, I have another dashed line horizontally across my screen. This will also indicate that there will be a page break between rows 43 and 44. So actually, this worksheet will be broken into four pages. Page 1 would be the main part of the data. Page 2 would be this part of the data from column E all the way down to row 43. Page 3 would be this part of the data from 44 on down to 51. And then finally, this area right here would be the fourth page. So if I wanted to set a page break, let's say right here, so that the page will break after column E, so it will break between column E and column F, and then between rows 8 and 9. I would position my cursor here. Excel will always cause a page to break above the active cell that you have selected and directly to the left. So let me go ahead and insert a page break, and notice that this is what you see, a page break between columns E and F and between rows 8 and 9, and you have a new set of dashed lines. Now the other technique for inserting a page break is to go through the page break preview mode. In this mode, you can simply drag the page break guide to the location where you want the break to fall. It's kind of a cleaner, more visual way to set a page break. So let me come down here to my status bar, and I will select the page break preview mode, and notice that some of my data is appearing off the page, indicating that this will appear on the second page. These dark solid blue lines are your page breaks, and you can see I have them set here as well as here vertically, and then farther down you'll have the page break fall right about here at the end of the page. So to adjust this, you simply need to position your cursor on the solid blue line, either vertically or horizontally. Notice that your cursor becomes a double arrow tool, and if you click and drag, you can adjust that page to break between columns E and F. Now I'd like to also get rid of this horizontal page break and cause this page to appear all on one sheet. So I'll position my cursor on this horizontal solid blue line, and notice again I get the double arrow tool, and I'll click and drag and pull this all the way down to the very bottom. Now I have forced this worksheet to appear all on one page, and if I take my magnification down, you will see that this spreadsheet now appears all on one page. Nice feature, the page break preview really works the best for setting page breaks. It's very visual, and it allows you to quickly and easily adjust how your page will break. Let's go ahead and apply page breaks to our project. And what we're going to do is open up a brand new worksheet. And on this worksheet, we're going to record our sales totals for our salespeople. So what I'd like you to do is click the Office button to expand down into the menu and then choose Open. We're going to open an existing file. And the file that I'd like you to open is 0713 start file. Go ahead and open this up by either double-clicking it or selecting it once and choosing open. This will open up a partially developed workbook for recording monthly sales of all the sales associates in the Raspberry Brigade. Notice that if I scroll down here, it appears that everything is all on one page. But if I go into my page break preview, you'll see that there is a page break that falls between columns D and E. And column E, which has the total for all the sales, is on page 2. So let's go ahead and adjust that so that this sheet of our workbook will always appear on one page. So what I'd like you to do is position your cursor on the solid blue line so that you get the double arrow tool, and then click and drag and pull that over so you have a break between columns E and F. And now the total column will appear on the same page as all the other data. Now let's go ahead and save this worksheet because we will be using it throughout the remainder of this course. So go again up to your Office button, select that, pull down to Save As, and just select the Save As command by clicking it once. And let's go ahead and name this workbook Monthly Sales. Make sure you are saving it in your Excel 2007 Chapter 7 directory. So with that set up, go ahead and click Save, and we will have the start for a new workbook for recording monthly sales for all our sales associates in the Raspberry Brigade. Now, with this saved, let's move on to the next movie.